In 2014, Brighton and Hove had a syphilis diagnosis rate 8 times the national average. I'm here at Terrence Higgins Trust today for the launch of Brighton Testing Week, which is there to encourage people to get tested for STIs. So I'm with Tom Boyd from the Terrence Higgins Trust. Tom, tell us a bit about Brighton Testing Week and why it's so important for people to get tested.
We do have a national HIV testing week, which happens later in the year in November. But we thought it was really important, as STI rates are high, one of the highest in the country within Brighton and Hove, to have a campaign outside of the testing week, HIV testing week, to remind people just how important it is to test regularly for STIs. Because STIs, which means sexually transmitted infections, they're very easily picked up, and you can have them and you can not have any symptoms with them. So you might have picked up an STI and you might not even realise that you have one. And you know, as easy as they are to pass on and catch, they're equally as easy to treat as well.
So are there any particular groups of people that should actually think about getting tested?
Yeah, well, first off, here at Terrence Higgins Trust, we're really focusing on men who have sex with men and Black Africans. So men who have sex with men, let's go with bisexual guys or anyone that has sex with men, basically, if you're a man. And basically, it's very easy to test. You can come here to the office. We've got extended opening hours from 10 a.m. till 8 p.m. Monday to Friday, all of this week. But also, we have pop-up testing stations throughout the city. So do look out for those. We're in various places, different times, late into the night, out of hours, which is great if you're working. So it's still easy to come and test. For all those details, please go to our website, which is www.tht.org.uk/Brighton tests, and there you'll find a full listing of all the pop-up stations which are out of hours.
So how easy is it to actually get tested?
Well, it's really very easy. I mean, there's lots of facilities available throughout Brighton and Hove, and I mean, literally to actually come into the office, fill out the necessary paperwork, do the test and leave. It takes about 5-10 minutes. Mm-hmm. So you know, you can pop in your lunch break, it is that easy. And results are delivered to you via text message. So, you know, so you don't have to go troopsing around or see someone else to get an appointment to get the results. They're delivered privately and confidentially to you.
And I'm actually going to do a test here, basically going to do an oral swab, aren't I?
That's right, yep. Yeah.
So let's just see how difficult or awkward or intrusive it actually really is.
Okay, so I mean, the oral swab, people say, is actually the most difficult one. So you've chosen the most tricky one there, Sophie. But basically, this is an oral swab.
Okay.
So STIs like chlamydia and gonorrhea, they can live in different parts of the body. So that's, you know, that's the throat, yeah. The anus, the penis, and the vagina. So basically, what we're doing is we're going to test your throat today for chlamydia and gonorrhea. Yeah. So what it is, it's a simple swab. It's like a large cotton bud, yeah. Just like so. So this was sterile. I'll pop it back. So all we ask to get a good oval swab is to the back of the throat, to the left, to the right, and right to the back. It might make you gag a little bit.
Come on then. Let's do it.
Do you want me to dive in or you have to do it yourself?
I'll tell you what, you do it. I'll, yeah, there you go.
Okay.
No.
So if you open your mouth and you say R, and put tongue out, yeah. That might be a little bit uncomfortable. There, to the left, and to the right. And there you go, job done. So you pop that back into the tube like so, and that's it done.
So it really is that easy. It's really important for anyone that thinks they might have been exposed to an STI to actually get tested. This is Sophie Cook for Latest TV here at Brighton Testing Week.